Oh, it's cold in here. I've got my blanket on. Oof. A bit warmer. I thought it was supposed to be May. Doesn't feel like May, it feels like January. Welcome to the show. It's Club Corbie for the 13th of May. Apparently. 2020. And on yesterday's show, we finished off our series of daily comic strips. And away they went into the vault. Possibly never to be seen again, because I don't know what's going to happen now in terms of what we're going to do next. But I found something for us to do on today's show, and maybe over the next couple of days, that's the rest of this week. And we're going to continue working in Club Studio Paint. This, you might remember, is some art that we did a couple of months ago. To commemorate the completion of issue 4 of Corbie and sort of the conclusion of the initial story arc over the first 4 issues. So, at the time, this was really sort of an experiment in just going back to pen and ink. And I didn't have any intention of doing anything more with it. but I think we could work on this over the next couple of days on stream and add some colour to it, fix up some things because there's a few issues here that I'm not 100% pleased with. And I think by the time we're done with this we could have a very nice sort of poster image once we make some corrections. And it'll be a nice small project that shouldn't drag on for weeks on end. We should be able to do this, just turn this around. Maybe not on today's show, it's going to take us a couple of sessions I think, but something achievable that wouldn't feel like a burden, and there's value in that as well. So I've added the blank layer underneath the main art. I've got the line art set to multiply, so we'll add any color beneath that. And I also have this reference chart that I use that helps me keep track of the characters' color schemes. So we will be referring to that as we go. So with that said, let's just sort of get started. We'll go back up to the line out there. And what we're going to do is we're going to make some corrections on this out, but we're not going to go over the top because I want this to be more of a colouring stream and not so much sort of a general COVID illustration stream. You know, I figured it would be a nice sort of change of pace. I actually think that line's a bit too thick, so thank you. Okay, I'm going to resist the temptation to fix up every little pixel, but we need to tune up the eyes a bit on camera in here. And one pupil's a little bit bigger than the other. Bit of a witch for things like that. With characters that have very sort of googly eyes, if we can keep them balanced. Okay, I'm going to add another layer underneath this that I'm going to fill with white just to fill in any gaps that I make as I'm sort of editing this art. And we're going to take this one thing at a time today. We're just going to do Corinne's first. What we'll do is we'll just make some small corrections to Corinne's line art, and then we'll colour her in, and then we'll move on and we'll do the next character, and we'll take them one at a time. And I don't think we're going to, in fact I know we're not going to get them all done today. Figure it might take us, you know, all of tomorrow's stream and possibly all of Friday's stream as well. But I think by the end of Friday's stream we should be in a position where we have a really nice colourful group shot of the cast of the comic and, you know, I'm hoping this is going to clean up very well and it's going to be a nice piece, and we might even be able to make this into a poster image, something we could add to the Corbie store. Auto save time. longer wait for a second of this. Saves. It's taking longer than usual. Okay, I really don't know what's going on. You guys can't see it, but I see a message that says saving and recovery information. And, oh, there it goes. Okay, right. I'm going to go into preferences. We're going to load dangerously. I'm going to disable that just now while we're working on stream here. It's disabled. Now I've got to remember to switch that back on once we're done here today, because you know, if it gets to the point where down the road I'm working on something and I lose my data, or Club Studio Paint Force just shuts down, which has happened to me more than once in the past, then I'm going to be kicking myself if I don't turn that back on. But for our purposes on stream, I think it's better if we just leave it shut off just now. This piece was done, really as an experiment in the whole sort of pen and ink art that we did for the daily strips that we could do. So it was done really in the same sort of style, using the same sort of materials. I just wanted to see what everybody would look like, what the cast would look like. Just done using traditional materials, and as a result of that we have a lot of the same things that we have to iron out here, in terms of sometimes we have some lines that have some gaps in them, sometimes the lines are a little bit rough, and sometimes there are areas of the image that just have mistakes that just need to be corrected. Thank you. Okay, we're gonna make just a few more tiny connections here. Again, I don't want to spend a whole lot of time doing line work connections because I figured this is gonna be a colouring stream. But let's get this art exactly the way that we want it to look before we start laying down the colours, and I think that's pretty close. The only other thing that I would perhaps connect is, oh, we can just adjust this line here, just clean this up just a little bit. The one thing, these lines aren't even. Thank you. another thing that I wanted to connect is perhaps let's move this down a bit. There you go, it's taken us half an hour to get to the point where we're ready to actually start laying down some colours here. But better late than never. So if we go up to our colour chart, start off by just laying down some skin tone. See, we're very deliberately going over the lines here. We're not just trying to stay within the confines of the face where the skin tone would be, we're actually going over it. So it's very deliberate so that we don't miss any, you know, gaps that are in there. So. A couple of different ways that we can do this, and my sort of method varies depending on what I'm doing and how I feel that day. What we'll do is we will pick out Quinn's hair. And just to help keep things easy to manage, we'll make a new layer for that just now. We'll consolidate all of our layers later on, but a nice mousy grey for Kevin's hair. That's what I call it. The shade of hair that Kevin has, it's a mousy grey. A mousy brown, I should say. Mousy greyish brown. Obviously it's not grey. But it's greyish. It's got like a tint of grey in it actually. But what we're going to do is, because our inner area is already coloured, we're going to try and avoid getting in the face with it. And we're just gonna keep this in a very simple cartoony style today, insofar as the style of colouring goes. We're not gonna do any kind of super elaborate shading or anything like that. Render every single hair on the head here.
Are you ready?
Now that we've filled in this sort of inner area of the hair, and hopefully we should have closed that loop. But if I've got rid of the paint bucket now. And we can start to trim off some of this excess as well. A bigger brush, we can cover more ground more quickly. There we go. Maybe miss a pixel here or there. And of course there's another area here that needs to be coloured in the brow, which is eyebrows. Okay. Right, next thing we're going to do, we're going to add another new layer, and we're going to lay down the whites of the eyes. Very simply. The shape of the eye here, actually, is a little bit odd, and maybe doesn't quite gel with that, so what we might do is go back up to our character art layer and we'll just tweak that a little. It's a very good idea, by the way, to name your layers. Something that you might have noticed I'm very bad at doing, but let's quickly do that just now, just in case we end up overwhelming ourselves. So line art. Right now we'll just call this one, we'll just call it the whites, because we're going to do more than just the eye whites. Here. we end up merging all these layers for Corinth colors, but that should be fine for now. Action of that. And if you paint with white on a multiply layer, to vanish. But anyway, go back to our whites that we were laying down. So we've got the white on eyes. We're also going to, on the same layer, the white for Kevin's teeth. I think you're going to find that once you get the eye whites in and the eye color and the teeth, that this is really where you start to see the character come to life. To me, this is probably the most exciting part of doing any character. Once you get these colors laid down, you always have to get a feel for what the character is going to look like, you see? Add the lip color. And at this point we won't even add a new layer, we'll just do it on the same one as the eyes just now. I find with very small details like this that don't need as much management, you know, sometimes you can just combine all of those parts into one layer while you are just laying down the flats. Okay, we might just end up going over the hair a little bit there. So if we catch ourselves doing that, we can hit Control Z. Back out. We really don't have a specific sort of end point here in terms of how far down do we go before we stop adding colour, so you know, we'll just improvise. As long as we make sure that there are no gaps, we can fill that in. That could be very tricky because sometimes you think there's not a gap and there actually is, and then it ends up filling the whole image and locks up your machine for a second, especially if you're working on a high-res image anyway. There's a detail missing there. We, for some reason, we didn't finish colouring in Kevin's neck, so we'll go back and we'll fix that afterwards. Sure that any lines that are going underneath the line are actually it doesn't leave any gaps, and then we can just hit the fill tool. We can fill those in. Back to the skin tone there, and I'm not thrilled about the way that this kind of ends here. what would be there, I suppose. It's just a little bit more there. I don't know, it just feels sort of lines end up. Okay, I feel a little bit better about that now. It was just, I think, getting all of the sort of end points there to line up correctly was proving to be a bit of a challenge. We still need to connect this though, I think. Okay, right, I think we have most of our, really all of our flat colours down there. Do we have anything else to add there? So, for Corinne, obviously, I mean, you can merge all of these elements together. Or in fact, we won't do that. What we'll do is, just to make management of it a little bit easier, we'll leave them all as individual layers just now, and we'll start to like I said, we're just going to keep our shading very simple here. We're just going to use the multiply layer and go in and add a few extra sort of passes here. Nothing too advanced. What we could do is, if we wanted to, go filter, blur, Gaussian blur, take some time to apply, because again this is a fairly high vis image that we're working with today. And, you know, that would soften it, but I think for our purposes today, we'll just leave it cell shaded. So we'll merge skin tone layer with the connections, sorry, with the shading for it, and then we'll move on and we'll start to shade the hair. Again, I can select all of the hair in one go. I can even add the eyebrows. Make a new layer above it. Make the back part of the hair here. Darkest. In fact, I think what we'll do is we'll just make a point of going in and get slightly a darker shade manually. Like that. And we'll do the same for the underside parts of the hair here. And then we can go back out to the outside of the hair, and we can just start to apply. The most challenging part about this is if you're using the multiply function to darken, you know, certain parts of the hair, then if you miss any gaps, if there's any gaps in there, you end up going back over them. What's probably going to happen is you're going to make the surrounding area that you've already drawn over even darker, so we need to try and make sure that we're very strategic about where we are placing our strokes. As an example, if I place another dot over this just to fill in this gap, you see how the center part there is even darker because I've already applied ink there, so we've got to be very careful. And there are ways around that, but don't want to spend too much time meddling today. This is another example of a part where we'd very easily get in it with that sort of overlap again. In fact, we did there just a little bit. One way that you can get rid of that, just blur it out. I guess it was just a tiny little dot like that. There we go. Basically, as long as you can do it all in one stroke without letting go of your pen button, keep going over that. That's one action. And that should be okay. What we could do I don't want to use a lot of excessive sort of lighting here, because I think that if you add a lot of lighting, you know, in every single component of your image, then you can end up with a sort of a very plasticky look, I think. But we'll make another layer above that, and we'll set that to screen. Across the top here. I really find less is more with that sort of thing. We could start to add bands of light here all over sort of the right side of every chunk of Corinne's hair, but in actual fact less is more, and probably we don't even need it to be super white as well. We can lower down the opacity there and just have it just be a sort of a lighter shade than the rest of the hair to show where the light is hitting from the right hand side, and that's going to make all the difference. We could go in and we could do a lot of sort of shiny graphical effects as sort of like a shimmer effect to across the top band of the hair, really go for that sort of old school anime look, but it doesn't really fit in with the house style that we've got going for Kirby. So what we'll do next is, God, that line is really starting to bug me. And I added that in as well. I'm gonna erase it. Let's just switch this back to, oh, yes, I missed something up there. What we're going to do is set this back to, I need to fix up something soon. Okay. No, just to help us manage things. We can. Merge these three layers together. See how each of the individual layers will combine to form the whole image that we've done so far. Anyway, next thing we're going to do is we're just going to add some shading to the shirt. Same process applies again. Really very simple here. Just think about which parts of the image are going to be cast in shadow, which are the darker components, and which parts are getting hit by the light. Add a little bit more shadow underneath the shirt collar as well. So. Might even give it an extra pass there. And again, we could give a little bit of extra polish by maybe just I think a little bit of light down the right hand side of her arm there. Okay, very simple stuff. And then we can merge these three layers. Just gonna merge selected layers. And that's that part done. Now, I think we're almost done here as far as Corinne goes. fact, really, that's all we need. We don't need to have an excessive amount of shading, because there really isn't any call for it. I wouldn't even add, the temptation might be to start to add in some light grey on the side there to show where the light hits the sweater vest, and the reason why I wouldn't do that is because I feel like the texture of the blouse is going to be more of sort of like a shiny material, and it's going to, the light is going to hit that more, just like the hair. The sweater vest, if you think about it, is going to be like a, probably like a wool sort of material, and light isn't really going to reflect off of it in the same way as the blouse would, so in this instance I would say keep it more, stick to more your sort of standard, your main colour and your shadow, and I would avoid having light sort of reflecting off of it. Anyway, so now that we've done that, we can merge the visible layers. That's going to give us Karen's colours. Excuse the American spelling. Why not? Now we have Karen's colours on one layer that we can manage. We can switch it on and off. And I would say that she is complete. So now we can move on and we can get started on another character. Who should we do next? Well, we start at the bottom, we'll work our way up. We'll get to Corbie at the end, I think. So maybe we'll do Jennifer next. Yeah, and we'll start off by just sort of fixing up the eyes, because eyes are a little bit wonky. Actually, I would say eyes are quite wonky. Yeah, eyes are not even either, although the head is tilted slightly at an angle, which may go some way towards explaining that. Again, we're gonna chop off a bit of the hair here because it's probably, well, it's definitely a bit uneven. Try and get things to be a bit more balanced. Okay, we're just gonna make our necessary corrections. Some things out. Before we start to get to what we came here for, which is to add our colours. Something in the result that I think. It's smooth. Perhaps the nose over a little bit as well. Thank you. Okay, I think we're about ready to start actually blending in the colours here. Oh, this is weird. Cross over there with some of the other character art. So. Let's thicken up this the jaw just a little bit, and then we will begin. Right, we're going to go back to our layers. And we'll start just as we did before. We will. Oh, you know what? Jennifer doesn't actually appear on the list. Okay, that's a bit of a... That's a thing. Okay. Just give me a sec, I'll go find some reference material with Jennifer in it and we'll use that. Instead. Here we go. What I'm going to do is I'll just drag and drop this panel from Kirby issue 3. And we will use this as our reference. We'll start with skin tone. So, yeah, there you go. Obviously, I need to update the color chart with all of the characters who've been. I was going to say all the characters who've been introduced since issue 1, but Jennifer was in issue 1, so I don't even have that excuse. That was fast enough. We'll go back, we'll pick out the hair colour. And these are all for, this is a JPEG from the web ready version of the comic, so hopefully the colour reproduction here is pretty good. And fairly faithful to what it was supposed to be. Yeah, not the best source material. In terms of for us to use to get accurate colours, but we're just going to have to hope that that JPEG is close enough. Jennifer doesn't have a model sheet in the way that many of the other characters did. Neither does Carlton, actually. The two of them, I never got around to creating full-size model sheets for them, and I think the reason for that is, from memory, I don't believe either of them were in issue 2 when I made the model sheets, so creating those just wasn't a priority at the time. We have got a little over 20 minutes left on today's stream, so I think we should have time to finish Jennifer's colours. That is going to be a little bit for the this show, and we'll come back tomorrow and we'll do a couple more characters. And we'll just repeat that, and we'll make this our little Club Corbie project. As opposed to, something where I keep going once the stream is over, we'll just do this. As an on-stream thing. I think it should be fairly safe to use the paint bucket tool there. gap here or there that we've missed. This whole sideburn area. Again, if we go over a little bit, we'll just trim that off. Denim jacket next. And we're not going to be afraid to go over the patches as well, because we'll cross that bridge when we come to it. Oh no, I made a terrible mistake. Oh, it's okay, I hit escape. I got out in time. If you ever accidentally fill something in Club Studio Paint and you realise that you've left a gap, you hit the escape key quick enough. No, it's still not it. Hit the escape key, you can cancel out and avoid having the whole canvas get filled with blue, which is what was going to happen there. There we go, that's much better. We have a similar sort of thing to what happened with Kevin's arm to torso here, where there's this sort of gap and I don't like it. So I think what we'll do is got a problem just maybe with that. Yeah, it actually looks a lot better that way. We might need to thicken out the line a little bit.
I seem to let it eat me up. You influence my frame of mind. My heart is stuck in a loop of your rhythm and rhyme. I try to replace you with something new, whilst my body tries hard, wriggle on the ground, dancing about the idea of you, whilst you decide if I belong to lost and found. You know I'm dying to reach out to you, I'm trying but you can't see. You say my calls never come through, why can't you just hear me? I'm crying cause
I don't like... This is very late in the day to start making connections like this. I don't like the way that jacket pockets line up and just the general sort of alignment of the jacket. It's sort of off-center a little bit. And we've got all this real estate on one side. But we don't have any other. I'm sure a lot of that is because we had to pull out the arm laying there, but
I felt pain every time you cry. You say you'll be back before I know it. What you always lie. I try to get on with somebody that's not you. Whilst I hide the pain that sits before my eyes. Dreaming about the idea of you. Whilst you decide.
Okay, hopefully. Yeah, I mean that's a little bit cleaner and more balanced. So, page 14 probably isn't going to give us very good spatial detail. If we go to page 15, I think we can get the eye colour from there, and that's going to be a bit better. Also, wonder how this slightly. Here we go. Maybe it was looking up and they're a little bit more aligned. We need to that kind of darker colour that goes in the pupil. And I'm not going to create a separate layer for each of these different sort of elements. We can keep these fairly self-contained. The lips as well. I'm not sure, but I think this patch is yellow in the center here. And I believe it is pink, the same as the lip color. And the other areas. I don't know if that's correct, I might need to go double check that. But for now, let's assume that's correct. It might actually be the other way around, but we've got like 2 minutes left on today's stream, so. You know, for now, we can work with this. We're not going to spend ages agonizing over it. Shall we wrap up there by just starting to add some shading and then leave it there for now. So it's fairly consistent between all of the different characters. We'll add some shading on this side. And pull it down there. That might be too much. There we go. Almost think that's too much. Sometimes, you know, you start to add in more layers of shading than you really need and it starts to feel a bit excessive. So. I need to make sure I'm selecting on correct layer. Otherwise, there's nothing to actually select, or not much anyway. And just like we did with Kevin, we're gonna pick out the darkest parts of the hair. And some really heavy shading there. And then again we add a little bit of skin action there. And maybe just a little bit down the center here as well. In fact, I don't like that, but then instead I'll get rid of that. We'll keep that, this is. Just a tiny little bit of the gap here that we've missed. at this point, I've kind of lost track of which layer is which, so we're going to need to merge all of these down at some point soon. And I think there's probably some scope to add a little bit more detail on Jennifer's the patches, maybe add a little bit of gloss to the lips, some extra sort of little bits of detail here and there, but I'd say at this point she's about 95% complete, let's say. So yeah, we've gone a little bit over time today, but I wanted to at least get Jennifer up to near completion point, and then we've done two characters today, so you know, maybe tomorrow we'll get two done, maybe we'll get more done, and we'll continue to work our way through this, make corrections on the art where there are just some little things here and there that could be better, and eventually get this all polished up to become a nice little bit of group art of our illustrious cast. But anyway, I think that's going to do it for today's show, and as always I want to thank you all for dropping by and watching the stream. As always, you can donate at ko-fi.com/Corbie or streamlabs.com/Corbie, and it's going to help keep these projects going. And other than that, I think that's going to be it for today. So I will see you tomorrow for the next edition of Club Corbie.